deal.
Being in a flow state has always been very empowering and deeply satisfying experience for me. So where it's my actions that seem to merge with this awareness, an easy flow that just seems to be in rhythm with my surroundings. I'm fascinated by this optimal state of human consciousness. Flow state is when you performed at your best and felt your best during it. It's that strong feeling of freedom and commitment that we get. Your skill level was equal to the challenge at hand, you were motivated, you had a clear idea of what you were actually trying to achieve, and there was immediate feedback on what you were actually doing. So when in flow, your mind is free from worry about failure. Your self-consciousness disappears. Your sense of time seems to change as you enter into this elated space. Completely focused on what you're doing as if nothing could stop you, and then boom, you're brought back to reality as your mind tries to make sense of what just happened. So the question is this, what if there was more to learn about flow as a life skill? And this fleeting glimpse into reality there of ourselves outside of this kind of conditioned mind of ours. And what if every time you got into flow, you were actually expressing your full potential? The very definition of self-actualization. So Abraham Maslow, a famed American psychologist for his work on humanistic psychology and for the development of the hierarchy of needs model, sought to understand human motivation. What he proposed is obviously, as we know, that survival was our strongest motivator and then fulfillment. However, what many of you might not know is that in his last 18 months of his life, between his first heart attack and his fatal second heart attack, what he called his post-mortem life, is that actually he flipped that model and inverted the model. So his near-death experience, what he found, is that the desire to understand our own true nature is as important as the needs of survival itself. So I can relate to this, although I didn't know it at the time, several years back when I was deep in depression and having suicidal thoughts. I came from a broken home and a father who struggled to find emotionally crippled and struggled to acknowledge really my successes. As long as I can remember, I didn't feel that I was actually good enough. And I carried this with me into adulthood, having immigrated to the UK after 7 and 7 and leaving home shortly after that for South England. I was to start my journey, a long journey, from a failed competitive surfing career to completing my honours degree at a top university. And in my final year of studies, with plans to go to the London Olympics as a trainer, a good friend of mine, Mervyn, passed away while surfing in Hawaii, and this really shocked me to my core. This scared the fear in me. And what actually happened was death was to become one of my greatest teachers in life. So determined to achieve success fast, I came to London, and forcing my will on life, you know, this idea of trying to control my outcomes, you know, I was this motivated, trained, this positive guy with all the positive mental attitude quotes. I studied all of them to try and cope, but I still wasn't finding the answer. And yet the more I pushed, the more life pushed back, and nothing seemed to be working, yet I felt I had tried everything. So my mind was dizzy with information and success strategies from this coach and that guru. I was kind of dragging my heels, and I grew even more disillusioned because of this, not realizing my ambitions. So when rock bottom finally arrived, I fantasized about the relief that might bring me. It's at rock bottom that life really gets interesting, and that the things that you thought were important aren't, and you get a lot of clarity. So 2 months prior to that, I started going to meditation classes as the last attempt to get out of my crazy mind. My mind was wild monkey in a cage, unable to sit still in silence for just a second. Fortunately, my teacher had great patience as I started to understand the nature of my mind, and especially this idea of consciously accessing flow at will through it. Unknown to me at the time, this teacher was preparing me for the final showdown with myself. To surrender control of my mind and trust in life completely. When I did let go, as if I was hanging from a bridge with nothing below me but clouds below, and not knowing what lay beyond. I didn't actually leave my flat for 3 days. Everything was a blur. I was lost in the turmoil of emotional and physical overwhelm by this point, as if floating at sea in a storm. I was beyond my own death, and felt as though I didn't even exist. The me as I knew it was dissolving around me. And I continue on the morning of the 4th day, with my head still on the pillow, I opened my eyes and I looked out the window to this calm sky. And it was the most surreal and unique experience of my life, where this calm within, the sense that everything was going to be okay, was hard to actually explain to others around me. And this was to bring a rapid turnaround in my life, like an elastic band stretch, snapping back into place. My energy and attitude was rebounding back so much so that amazing opportunities started to come my way as if by magic, and that's how I had to explain it. The only way to describe this feeling was like being on a wave, going with the flow of things and responding intuitively to whatever came up. I was suddenly clear about my life and had discovered through all of this that happiness is not on the other side of success, as before. And I teach these principles of flow to help others to realize their full potential both here in SA and internationally. It's my way of giving back, and I can actually make a career out of it. So 2 years later, after all of that showdown, I was on one way to go back to South Africa. My 17-year journey overseas had come full circle. I now live the life that I've been dreaming of for so long. And the funny thing was, is that what I was looking for had always been with me all along. So self-actualization, here's the thing, it's an awakening, and then it's a constant process of becoming, rather than some glorious endpoint that we end up in life. So find your flow, realize you're already enough, and actualize your full potential.